My name is Jussi Oksanen, and I put this DVD together to help you out how to jump in the park. I'll be touching base on my favorite tricks, starting from straighters through 900s. And throughout the movie, I'm gonna give you my best advice how to pull these tricks off. We're also gonna go over some basic tuning stuff and some park safety. So hopefully you're gonna enjoy this movie and find this movie helpful for your riding. So just go out there and have fun. Enjoy. Okay, we're gonna go over some safety stuff. There are a few things we need to get straight first. Snowboarding is a very dangerous sport, and attempting jumps only increases that danger and potential for injuries. There's this program called Smart Style. It's really helpful. When you enter in a park, you see a bunch of orange logos, and there's a lot of things that you need to know, and we gotta go through all of them. It's pretty much common sense. I'm gonna let you know what they all mean. Know this symbol, Freestyle Terrain Park. It lets you know when you enter in the park. Look before you leap, it's only common sense. Before you start hitting any of the jumps, you wanna check out the takeoffs, landings, and know all the features, what they have in the park. Respect gets respect. Respect the terrain, other riders, and wait for your turn. And in the landing zones, get yourself out of there as quickly as possible. Easy style it. Take it easy out there, take it chill, work your way up. There's no pressure, there's no rush. Just the point is to learn some stuff and have fun out there. We're gonna start with straighters. Straighters are essential for everything. First, you have to learn how to handle your speed, how to take off properly, how to control yourself in the air, and how to land. To learn how to do a proper straighter is gonna help you to build a smooth style, and it gives you solid base to move forward to further tricks. Make sure that you start with the straightforward tabletops where the consequences are low. Make sure that you're gonna master this trick before you go any other tricks, because this is where it starts and this is where it's at. First, you want to take a few setup turns so you're all ready for the takeoff. Make a nice ollie, which will allow you some smooth air time. Approach the takeoff nice and straight. Stay on flat base all the way through the takeoff. Grab your board and keep looking straight. Snap a nice ollie off your tail, and that puts you in a balance all the way. Right here, you want to tuck down with your knees. Are you able to get the smooth ollie off the takeoff? Stay equally balanced on both feet and stay on your flat base. Grab your board and keep your shoulders straight. Right here, you want to give a little tweak, but still keep looking the landing zone. Here you can see my eyes totally locked on to a landing spot all the way through. Before the landing, bring your body back in line so you're nice and square. Release your grip, keep looking at the landing all the way, and land on your base nice and solid. Have a couple setup turns. Put your board in the flat base before the takeoff. Snap an ollie off your tail. Grab your board. Keep looking straight ahead all the way through. Land on your base nice and smooth. We're gonna go over switch straighter. We already know how to do straighter. And this is pretty much the same thing, and it's just gonna set you up for a lot of things we're gonna go over in the future. Switch stance means approaching the jump backwards. The key thing is just to get very, very comfortable riding switch stance before you even think about hitting any jumps, because you know that could be a pretty deep trouble right there. Same thing here as with the straighter. A few setup turns so you get all ready for the switch straighter. Make sure you're coming in flat based, snap an ollie of your tail, grab your board, check the landing, land nice and smooth. Coming in flat based, bend your knees and get ready to ollie. Pop a nice ollie off the takeoff, grab your board as soon as possible, which helps you to stay in balance and keep your shoulders in line with the slope. Follow the takeoff all the way through and snap that ollie off your tail. Stay well balanced on both feet, keep your shoulders straight, and that will help you to stay in line the whole way. Follow the tranny all the way through, grab your board, and keep looking at that landing spot. Halfway through, you should have a good vision of the landing and get focused on stomping your switch air. Remember to keep your shoulders straight, in line with the slope, and keep looking at the landing all the way. Land nicely balanced on both feet, stay nice and square, and ride out like a champ. Okay, backside 180. It's just one of those classic, simple tricks. You're gonna have a lot of air time as you spin very slow. You can make it stylish. It looks good and it feels good. It's just a great floater trick. Yeah, first you want to take those few setup turns and then try to approach the takeoff flat based. So now you come in on your flat base, keep looking straight all the way into the takeoff. Keep your balance in the center of your board and start slightly rotating your shoulders towards the backside spin. And at this stage, you want to spin very slow. Follow the takeoff all the way through, your shoulders are still straight as you're almost doing straighter. Until as soon as you're in the air, you want to start rotating with your head and shoulders. Start turning your shoulders towards the backside spin, grab your board and spin very slow. In the middle, you can see how I turn my head over to the landing spot. It's very important so you can see where you're going. Give a good old tweak and that will also help you to control your spin better. You spotter your landing, bring your shoulders around and get ready to stomp. Land flat based or slightly on your toe wedge, nicely balanced in the center. Come in flat based as you're doing a straighter, snap an ollie of your tail, bring your shoulders around, spot your landing, land flat based and center balanced. Switch backside 180. Frontside half grab, same thing, you just got different names. Anyways, it's the same thing as a backside 180. Only thing, you're gonna approach the jump, switch, and you're gonna land regular. I want you to really get into this because we're gonna have a lot more switch backside spins coming up. So get this dialed first and then we can get into other things.
Coming in switch stance, get yourself balanced before the takeoff, come in flat based, grab your board and start turning your shoulders around while you're tweaking. Right here where the training starts, you want to crouch down a little to get ready to snap an ollie.
Your body is still straight all the way through the takeoff. In the air, start turning your head towards the spin.
Right here, flat base, shoulders straight, pop a nice ollie and start spinning slow. Snap a nice ollie if you tell, start turning those shoulders, grab your board and spot that landing. You might slightly be on your toe edge on the lift, that's fine, but just stay straight with your shoulders so you don't start spinning too much up the lift. Try to spot your landing when you spin 90 degrees through your legs. If you can, that's going to help you a lot. Release your grab and get ready to land flat base and nice and balanced. Take off from base or slightly from the toes. Start turning your shoulders as well as grabbing your board. Spot your landing, land nice and smooth.
We're gonna go over frontside 360, which is one of my favorite tricks. It's quite a big step from the tricks we've gone through before, as it's the first 360, but don't worry about it. Pretty straightforward. I'm gonna pinpoint all the stuff you need to know, and I promise you learn this in no time. Make sure you check the speed first with the straighter. Run in, make a few mellow turns to get yourself all set up for frontside tree. Right here, you want to put your board in the flat base before the takeoff. On the takeoff, start slightly leaning onto your heel edge to get ready for that frontside rotation. The takeoff, all the way through, snap a nice ollie of your tail. Start opening your shoulders towards the frontside rotation, and then tilt halfway through, keep looking out straight ahead. Pop a nice ollie, keep checking straight so you get the good view where you're going. Halfway through, check your landing spot and start slowing your rotation. When you give it a little tweak, it's also a good way to slow your spin down a little. Bring your shoulders around, keep your eyes closely on the landing all the way in the end. Try to land in on your flat base or slightly on your toe edge. First, a few setup turns, approach the takeoff on your flat base. Start slightly leaning onto your heel edge. Start turning your shoulders towards the frontside rotation, right out, nice and clean. Okay, cab 360. I find this trick very hard sometimes with a 10 to over-rotate it to 540. What I have found it helpful is to think the last 180 rotation has a backside 180, and that's a slow smite spin right down.
Okay, coming in switch stance. Take off from your heel edge, and that sends you off to your cab 3. Start leaning onto your heel edge, and start opening your shoulders towards the cab rotation. Okay, right here you can see that my shoulders are open a little, which makes my spinning part very easy. Crouch down a little, and start leaning onto your heel edge, which comes naturally with the rotation. This trick is easy to spin too fast, so think the last 180 rotation as you're doing backside 180, and that's gonna help you slow your spin. Just keep reminding yourself that you wanna spin very slow all the way through. Keep looking straight towards the landing as long as you can, as the last part will be blind. Land exactly like you land your backside 180, solidly onto your base. You come in and switch, start slightly leaning onto your heel edge, open your shoulders for the rotation, grab your board, and land it like you land your backside 180s.
Okay, we're getting into switch backside 360. As long as you have a switch backside 180 all dialed, you shouldn't have any problems with it.
Coming in switch, approach the takeoff flat base, pop a nice ollie, which allows you enough airtime for switch backside 3. On the takeoff, your weight is going to shift slightly onto your toe edge. At the takeoff, you start turning your front shoulder towards the switch backside spin. Crouch down for the ollie, follow the tranny all the way through, and snap that ollie of your tail. Have a nice takeoff and let your head lead your body into the spin. Smooth ollie, grab your board and enjoy the trip. Coming in nice and solid, have a good ollie, keep your head leading the spin, and then you will spot the landing as soon as you come around. After 180, you want to keep your eyes on the landing all the way and land it solid. We're coming in switch, take a few setup turns, smooth ollie off the lip, start rotating while you're grabbing your board, spot the landing and land it solid.
Backside files are pretty dope, but in my book harder than a backside sevens. The rotation is fairly easy, but the landing part it gets more difficult as you come around blind and you can land switch stance.
Get set up, you will take off from your toe edge, crouch down so you get a nice ollie, start turning your shoulders and spin around nice and smooth. Leaning onto my toe edge and look at my shoulders here, I got them in a position ready to rotate, then just keep leaning with your head towards the spin to keep your momentum going. Here you can check it out how much I'm leaning onto my toes on the takeoff. Snap a good ollie off your tail and here you can see that my head is already in place that I can see the landing. At this point, spot the landing and you will have already completed the most crucial part of the spinning. A few turns, shift your weight onto your toes, start rotating your upper body towards the spin, grab your board and keep your head leading the spin, spot the landing as early as possible, slow your spin down like you're doing backside 180s, landing on your toe edge just to be safe.
Switch backside fives are one of my favorite tricks. It's very nice rotation and you can really tweak in on this one. Plus, you're gonna land regular, which means you should have it pretty dialed by now. Come in switch stance, line yourself up on the running to get ready to take off from your toe edge. Start leaning onto your toe edge and start turning your head and shoulders towards the spin so you get the smooth rotation. Again, start turning your head and shoulders. Try not to lean too far forward onto your toe edge as then you might lose the pop and might trip too much. Follow the takeoff all the way through and that allows you smooth air time. At the takeoff, look over your back shoulder. After 180, look straight so you can see where you're going. You can feel how fast you have to spin the rest. Grab your board and keep the rotation floating all the way. Keep looking straight towards the landing, but still have your front shoulder leading the rotation all the way through. Spot the landing as early as possible and keep looking at it all the way until the end. In the middle, look straight and see where you're going. When you come around, spot the landing and finish your rotation, land it straight and solid. Coming in switch stance, take off from your toe edge, start rotating your shoulders and head towards the spin, grab your board and keep your front shoulders and head leading the spin and stump it clean. Frontside fives, it's a very important trick to learn. It's a building block to learn other tricks. It's going to put you in the right track for frontside sevens and frontside nines.
Okay, you want to figure out your speed first. Come in nice and solid and take off from your heels. Start leaning onto your heel edge as well as rotating your shoulders. Snap an ollie off your tail and start turning your shoulders towards the frontside spin. Have your head lead you with the rotation, that way you get a smooth spin all the way through. Grab your board and keep your head leading the spin. When you come around, keep looking straight to the landing and start slowing your rotation. Get ready to land center balance and keep looking straight down with the slope. Have a few turns, start leaning onto your heel edge, start rotating with your head leading the spin, and land nice and solid.
Cat 5. As long as you have Cat 3 in the back, this should be a piece of cake. A lot of the pro riders call it as a safety trick. As you land regular, and the entire rotation is very simple.
Okay, first you want to get comfortable in the running and start shifting your weight onto your heel edge. Start turning your upper body towards the spin, and you want to face the direction where you're going to. Also, start bringing your arms into the rotation and keep slightly leaning over your front shoulder. Try to stay quite center balanced, as otherwise you're going to cork it more than you want it. And now you got a smooth takeoff. Grab your board as well as twisting your head over the landing direction. Okay, now you already turn your shoulders at the lip. Now you just want to keep leaning over your shoulders all the way to maintain that rotation you got from the takeoff. Check out my head, how I already have the landing zone in view. That's how you want to be at this stage. Now you have the spin dialed. Now you just want to finish the spin, bring your shoulders all the way around, and keep checking that landing all the way through. This trick is nice as you get an early view of the landing while you're in the air. Try to stomp it solid like you've been doing with all the other tricks. Approach the takeoff on your heel edge. Start turning your head and shoulders so you're facing straight towards the landing. Grab your board and keep leaning towards the rotation with your upper body, and you should be straight from there on.
Frontside sevens. It's very important that you get that full rotation straight from the lip, so you don't need to huck with your body, unless you want to look like a circus man.
Okay, you want to cruise in and take a wide turn before the jump to put you on the right track from the takeoff. Now you start leaning onto your heels and you start bringing your arms level with your shoulders, which will help you out with the rotation. Open your shoulders towards the spin, then just keep leaning that way with your head and upper body. So now you're shifting your weight onto your heels, start bringing your shoulders and arms around, then follow the takeoff all the way through to get the maximum pop. Now you get a nice pop of the takeoff, then grab your board and keep spinning. Maintain that momentum, leading the rotation with your head. There are a few easy grabs which will help you out with the spin. Melons, indies, and mutes are the ones you should start with. Check out my head, I'm looking over my shoulder, that way I can see the landing as early as possible. When you have spotted the landing, by this point your body should naturally continue the spin without much effort from you. Okay, here you can see again, I'm already done with the most part of the spin. For the last part, I'm just focusing on the landing and letting it bring itself around. Finish the spin and try to stomp it onto your toe side. That way, if you didn't get quite as much spin, there's more room for error. Cruise and get yourself comfortable. Start leaning onto your heels. Bring your upper body towards the rotation. Grab your board and keep your head leading the spin. Spot the landing and finish the rotation. Stomp it clean.
Cab sevens can be pretty tricky sometimes. You've got some options with it. You can take off from your heel edge or your toe edge. I prefer it taking off my heel edge, as it gives me a smooth rotation, as well as I'm able to grab my board easier all the way through.
Use a lot of the basics from the Cat 5, the few turns and shift your weight onto your heels. The key thing is to have it balanced center of the board, as otherwise you will start spinning all over the place. Here you can see how I start turning my arms around and also how much I'm leaning onto my heel edge. In there, keep rotating your head and shoulders around to keep that momentum going. The airtime is very much like the backside 540. Okay, when you come around and you see the landing, still keep leaning into the spin so you get the full rotation. Try to stomp it with your weight slightly on your toes. Shift your weight onto your heels, have your balance in the center of the board, start leaning into the rotation with your head and shoulders, spot the landing and finish your rotation.
So it's backside sevens. This is my favorite trick when it comes down to bigger spins. You might find this pretty hard trick at first, but it is well worth the effort.
As far as the basics, it will be identical to Swiss backside five. On a takeoff, you start shifting your weight onto your toes and start turning your upper body towards your spin. I keep my knees bent and my balance slightly back, which helps me to get the rotation going. Okay, here you can see the same thing again. Bend your knees, balance slightly in the back, and the key thing is to rotate your head and shoulders. That way you get a smooth spin. Here's a close-up so you can really see what's going down. Here's another angle. You can see how I twist my body around, and that gives me the maturity of the spin. Follow the takeoff all the way through. Grab your board and keep your head leading your spin and stay compact with your body. Having your head leading the spin, you can spot the landing as early as possible. Still keep leaning to backside direction. When you finally spot the landing, keep your eyes fixed on it all the way and your body will automatically come around. Again, look straight ahead, see where you're going, keep leaning into the spin, spot your landing and let your body come around, land solidly on your base or your weight slightly on your toes. Same basics as in Swiss backside five. Shift your weight onto your toes, start rotating your body towards the spin, grab your board, spot the landing and stomp it onto your base or slightly on your toes.
Front side nine. Now you have front side seven in the bag, so you should have a pretty good idea how to make that front side nine rotation. Remember that you do need a bigger jump for this to be able to pull it off nice and clean.
Okay, here you want to have a smooth turns and get all set up for the front side nine. Your weight is onto your heels and you start already rotating your shoulders and arms so you can get the full rotation straight off the lip. Here I'm leaning onto my heels and my shoulders are already open for the spin, then snap a coup d'oeil off your tail. You want to wait until very end of the takeoff to pop your ollie, as this will give you the maximum amplitude to pull your trick off. In the middle of your spin, try to spot where your landing is, as often you will have to reevaluate whether you need to spin faster or slower. Coming in solid, in the air, I want to hold my grab as long as possible because that's going to keep me balanced all the way around. Keep leaning your head and shoulders towards the spin. When you do that, you're also going to spot the landing as early as possible. Around 630 degrees, you should spot the landing over your front shoulder and keep your eyes fixed on it all the way. A few turns, start leaning onto your heel edge, start leaning over your front shoulder, grab your board, keep your body compact and keep leaning your head towards the spin, spot the landing and stomp it as you would your front side fives.
Swiss backside nines is definitely the hardest trick I'm covering in this movie, so just build your way up nice and smooth and get that Swiss backside seven as dialed as possible, and then you can start with some nines. It's a natural step, there's no rush, so just take your time with it.
Get all comfortable in the running, then start slightly shifting your weight onto your toe edge. Take a wide turn so you get properly set up. Your weight is now on your toes. Then start turning your front shoulder and head towards the spin, and this will provide your momentum. Try to broach the takeoff as straight as possible and start turning your upper body towards the spin, and make sure you will snap the ollie at very end of the takeoff. On the takeoff, rather have your balance more in the center of your board than back, as if you lean too much back, it will throw you too much coy and you will end up on your butt. Take off again. Try to bring your arms, shoulders and head forward the direction of the spin to get the momentum. In the air, keep your body in the same alignment as in the takeoff to maintain that momentum all the way. Grab your board as early as possible and try to stay very compact with your body. That way it's easy to keep on spinning. Around 360 degrees, you want to give a little whip with your upper body, which gives you a boost to spin all the way around. This is the same shot again, but in real time, you can see how I whip my body around. First, you get the rotation started from the takeoff. Then in the air, you give it a little whip to maintain the spin. Here, you evaluate where you are with the rotation while letting the momentum bring you all the way around. Take those few setup turns, then start slightly shifting your weight onto your toes. On the takeoff, start rotating your upper body in the air. Whip it with your head and shoulders. Keep the momentum going and land it as perfectly as you land now every other trick.
There you go. I shared my top 16 tricks with you. Hopefully you enjoyed watching my video and hope you learned something new. If it's a straighter, that's great. If you work yourself up to switch back side nines, it might be time to start hitting the sponsors. Go out there, have fun, and most importantly, be safe.
In the hot box. It's like it's not hot enough outside, eh? Gotta come here in the sauna. Sweat your ass up. I need to put like an AV dripping through my veins.
Hi, my name is Jussi Oxenen. I have put this DVD together. Just take a chill out there. Work yourself up. It's nice and smooth. Okay. Cab sevens. Okay. See, it's before you leave. The greater the risk becomes.
You get our photographer, load rider.
I'll be trying to help you out through the movie I have with this DVD to get together to help.
Nice.
That it's eat for me. We're gonna cover switch. Were you filming? Now you get that full rotations, straight of rotations. My heel edge as it gets, you can take out as take your time. It's a cab three. And they, yeah. So build, make your way up. They let you know that don't go over or go, okay. As the rotation is very smooth and yeah. It feels good, it floats, you can enjoy it.
Just to let you know.
I'd be like when it said,
that
bear.
I can barely stay on my 2 feet anymore. I'm so tired, so sore, from sand. I think I've never been this sore in my career, just from snowboarding. Yeah, I don't think I've ever been this sore without falling. This is ridiculous. So you better enjoy this movie.